Global markets are changing constantly and rapidly. The industry faces a range of influences, such as ongoing interest rate changes, new technologies, the move to T+1, the settlement within a day of transactions completion in the US, and discussions about the future setup of capital markets in the EU.
So what does this mean for post-trading, and how do we efficiently and safely connect investors and issuers in this changing world? Well, to look at these questions, we're joined by Stephanie Eckermann, Chairwoman of Clearstream and member of the Executive Board, Deutsche Börse AG. Welcome, Stephanie. It's great to have you here on Sibos TV. Let's get straight into it. What do you currently see as the greatest challenges to the post-trading industry?
Well, I guess, the big challenge clearly is the lack of harmonization across jurisdictions, systems, across market participants in terms of non-standardized processes and data, no? And that leads to a world where we're still very reliant on manual work, and that is expensive and error-prone. And we see a continuous margin compression in the industry, a buy side that's now also need to manage total cost of ownership. And I mean, that is a challenge. And there we need to deliver efficiencies also on the post-trading layer.
And so that really kind of underlines the role of technology. How do you see technology as really helping overcome some of these challenges?
Now, I mean, while it is not a silver bullet, technology is a clear role to play in delivering that efficiency now. And that's how we use and deploy technical advancements at Clearstream. We use a mix of technologies with a focus on cloud migration, data and AI, digitization and tokenization of processes. And if you take our flagship, so to say, it's our digital securities platform, D7, that is really a proven record on the efficiency it delivers and the scalability. Now, we were able to decrease time to market from days to less than 6 minutes. And it really scales now. We have now more than 180,000 transactions issued via that platform, more than 10 billion in asset volumes. So that is really proven that technology can support that now.
Now, currently, after high inflation and rising interest rates, rates are coming down. Do you see this as a big challenge within the industry?
Yes and no. I think not that rates are coming down. I think that is now we're back into a normal, hopefully normal interest rate cycles. I do not see us going back to a quantitative easing and negative interest rates as we've seen it before. So what I think is that the scarcity of collateral and liquidity will stay. And that is a challenge for banks that need to manage these scarce resources efficiently and in compliance with regulation. And there we see a lot of demand of our clients for analytics, reporting solutions like our collateral mapper. And we see that clients value when we can bring our collateral management capabilities to other markets, regions, like, for example, the Canadian market in our partnership with TMX.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of those regulations, I want to stay in the U.S. here, recently moved to T+1 earlier this year. A lot of challenges for market participants. How do you see it from a global perspective?
We've seen a couple of our global clients having challenges with the alignment of settlement cycles. But I think overall, the industry has done a good job in all. And from a Clearstream perspective, we stand ready. We're already able today to cater our settlement capabilities with very flexible durations. Now, I mean, in line with regulation, but from a technical perspective, we are able to process any T+N durations. And I guess also for Europe, it's not a question if, but when T+1 will come. There will be a new ESMA proposition coming out probably until the end of this year. And I guess for Europe, it will be important that it's an aligned move of the EU, UK and Switzerland. And then I think Europe can be an important bridge between the Asian and the American time zone.
Speaking of Europe, there's currently intensive discussions within Europe on the future of capital markets within the EU, with the Draghi report, of course, published last month. What are your views on this?
We as Clearstream and Deutsche Börse, we highly support the renewed push in the Capital Markets Union. Now it would be great to develop now a competitive savings and investment union, as they call it, and we highly appreciate harmonization across Europe. Now, looking at post-trade, I think post-trade only will not do the trick. Now, if you look at Europe, there's a very fragmented world of different policies and regimes. There's a fragmented trading layer where the amount of securities trading that's outside the regulated exchanges is far higher than in the US. And there is a fragmented clearing layer. So this will all need to play together. Looking at post-trade, I think there's also some lessons to learn. There's quite some success factors, success stories you could look at if you take the euro bonds. That's a pan-European investment vehicle offering flexibility, competitiveness, and a global investor base. And that is, for example, a success story to learn from.
You talk about fragmentation there. If you look at the US, they have one central securities depository. In the EU, it has 27 CSDs. Couldn't the US be a role model here?
That is a very often asked question. No, I mean, I think you have to demystify first. No, if you look at Europe and the settlement that goes via central bank money and the T2S system, if you look at the three large CSD groups, they already today have 80 to 90% of the volumes or transaction numbers. So I think that is quite a good market structure, and I wouldn't know why a monopoly would be better for Europe. And then also, if you look at the US, just taking the US structure and putting it onto Europe will not solve the trick, no, because Europe is different. We still have 27 markets, 27 policy regimes, tax regimes, securities laws. And that is an harmonization that we have to solve to make Europe competitive.
I want to ask you about Clearstream, and I understand that CEO of Clearstream, Sam Riley, is going to be speaking tomorrow. So interested in hearing what is going to emerge from that. But Clearstream is not only active in security services, but also provides fund services. In the fund service industry, experts really agree that the most significant opportunities for growth and innovation lie in private placements. What's your view on this?
Clearstream has been active in private markets for a decade already. So now that everyone is talking about, we're very happy to continue to support this asset class. And our fund services offering ensures access to private markets via existing distribution channels. And it streamlines access across all asset classes and custody and settlement, and provides central data management and dissemination.
Earlier mentioned the ECB trials. I wondered if you can tell us a little bit more about your experiences here and where you think Europe is headed.
Yeah. So Clearstream is participating in all three trials. So we have currently six live use cases. And for us, the participation in the trials have been super successful. Now there is invaluable insights we gained out of it. Now the ECB trials are set up to explore the usage of DLT in central bank money settlement and in the development towards a digital euro. We were working with a range of partners, central banks, national and international banks across asset classes, duration, volumes. And for us, it has been really successful. And that's why we call for an immediate lead over of the successful trial infrastructure into a transitory solution, and that could serve then as a nucleus for the development of a stable long-term solution. That would be an enormous milestone in the development of a digital finance ecosystem in Europe that is competitive.
Fascinating stuff. Stephanie, I'm sure you've got plenty more conversations to have over the course of a very busy Sibos 2024. Thank you so much for joining us here on Sibos TV. That's Stephanie Eckermann, member of the Executive Board, Deutsche Börse AG, and Clearstream Chairwoman. Thanks again.
Thank you.